This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A 3D scanner is a device that analyzes a real-world object or environment to collect data on its shape and possibly its appearance, e.g. color. The collected data can then be used to construct digital three-dimensional models. Many different technologies can be used to build these 3D scanning devices. Each technology comes with its own limitations, advantages and costs. Many limitations in the kind of objects that can be digitized are still present. For example, optical technologies encounter many difficulties with shiny, mirroring or transparent objects. For example, industrial computed tomography scanning can be used to construct digital 3D models. Applying non-destructive testing, collected 3D data is useful for a wide variety of applications. These devices are used extensively by the entertainment industry in the production of movies and video games. Other common applications of this technology include industrial design, orthotics and prosthetics, reverse engineering and prototyping, quality control, inspection and documentation of cultural artifacts. Contents 1. Functionality 2. Technology 21. Contact 22. Non-contact active 221. Time of flight 222. Triangulation 223. Strengths and weaknesses 224. Kinoscopic holography 23. Handheld laser scanners 24. Structured light 25. Modulated light 26. Volumetric techniques 261. Medical 262. Industrial 27. Non-contact passive 271. User-assisted image-based modeling 3. Reconstruction 31. From point clouds 32. From models 33. From a set of 2D slices 34. From laser scans 4. Applications 41. Construction industry and civil engineering 42. Design process 43. Entertainment 44. Law enforcement 45. Reverse engineering 46. Cultural heritage 461. Michelangelo 462. Monticello 463. Cuneiform tablets 464. Kasubi tombs 465. Plastico di Roma Antica 466. Other projects 47. Medical CAD CAM 48. Quality assurance and industrial metrology 5. See also 6. References. Functionality 3D scanning of a fin whale skeleton in the Natural History Museum of Slovenia, August 2013. The purpose of a 3D scanner is usually to create a point cloud of geometric samples on the surface of the subject. These points can then be used to extrapolate the shape of the subject, a process called reconstruction. If color information is collected at each point, then the colors on the surface of the subject can also be determined. 3D scanners share several traits with cameras. Like most cameras, they have a cone-like field of view, and like cameras, they can only collect information about surfaces that are not obscured, while a camera collects color information about surfaces within its field of view. A 3D scanner collects distance information about surfaces within its field of view. The picture produced by a 3D scanner describes the distance to a surface at each point in the picture. This allows the three-dimensional position of each point in the picture to be identified for most situations. A single scan will not produce a complete model of the subject. Multiple scans, even hundreds, from many different directions are usually required to obtain information about all sides of the subject. These scans have to be brought into a common reference system, a process that is usually called alignment or registration, and then merged to create a complete model. This whole process, going from the single range map to the whole model, is usually known as the 3D scanning pipeline technology. There are a variety of technologies for digitally acquiring the shape of a 3D object. A well-established classification divides them into two types, contact and non-contact. Non-contact solutions can be further divided into two main categories, active and passive. There are a variety of technologies that fall under each of these categories. Contact, a coordinate measuring machine with rigid perpendicular arms. Contact, 3D scanners probe the subject through physical touch, while the object is in contact with or resting on a precision flat surface plate, ground and polished to a specific maximum of surface roughness. Where the object to be scanned is not flat or cannot rest stably on a flat surface, it is supported and held firmly in place by a fixture. The scanner mechanism may have three different forms: a carriage system with rigid arms held tightly in perpendicular relationship and each axis gliding along a track. Such systems work best with flat profile shapes or simple convex curved surfaces. An articulated arm with rigid bones and high precision angular sensors. The location of the end of the arm involves complex math, calculating the wrist rotation angle and hinge angle of each joint. This is ideal for probing into crevasses and interior spaces with a small mouth opening. A combination of both methods may be used, such as an articulated arm suspended from a traveling carriage, for mapping large objects with interior cavities or overlapping surfaces. A CMM coordinate measuring machine is an example of a contact 3D scanner. It is used mostly in manufacturing and can be very precise. The disadvantage of CMMs, though, is that it requires contact with the object being scanned. Thus, the act of scanning the object might modify or damage it. This fact is very significant when scanning delicate or valuable objects such as historical artifacts. The other disadvantage of CMMs is that they are relatively slow compared to the other scanning methods. Physically moving the arm that the probe is mounted on can be very slow, and the fastest CMMs can only operate on a few hundred hertz. In contrast, an optical system like a laser scanner can operate from 10 to 500. This litter scanner may be used to scan buildings, rock formations, etc. To produce a 3D model, the litter can aim its laser beam in a wide range. Its head rotates horizontally, a mirror flips vertically. The laser beam is used to measure the distance to the first object on its path. The time of flight 3D laser scanner is an active scanner that uses laser light to probe the subject. At the heart of this type of scanner is a time of flight laser range finder. The laser range finder finds the distance of a surface by timing the round trip time of a pulse of light. A laser is used to emit a pulse of light, and the amount of time before the reflected light is seen by a detector is measured. Since the speed of light c is known, the round trip time determines the travel distance of the light, which is twice the distance between the scanner and the surface. If t is the round trip time, then distance is equal to c. 2. The accuracy of a time of flight 3D laser scanner depends on how precisely we can measure the t. Time, 33 picoseconds approximately, is the time taken for light to travel 1 mm. The laser range finder only detects the distance of one point in its direction of view. Thus, the scanner scans its entire field of view one point at a time. By changing the range finder's direction of view to scan different points, the view direction of the laser range finder can be changed either by rotating the range finder itself, or by using a system of rotating mirrors. The latter method is commonly used because mirrors are much lighter and can thus be rotated much faster and with greater accuracy. Typical time of flight 3D laser scanners can measure the distance of 10,000, approximately 100,000 points every second. Time of flight devices are also available in a 2D configuration. This is referred to as a time of flight camera triangulation. Principle of a laser triangulation sensor: two object positions are shown. Triangulation based 3D laser scanners are also active scanners that use laser light to probe the environment. With respect to time of flight 3D laser scanner, the triangulation laser shines a laser on the subject and exploits a camera to look for the location of the laser dot. Depending on how far away the laser strikes a surface, the laser dot appears at different places in the camera's field of view. This technique is called triangulation because the laser dot, the camera, and the laser emitter form a triangle, the length of one side of the triangle. The distance between the camera and the laser emitter is known. The angle of the laser emitter corner is also known. The angle of the camera corner can be determined by looking at the location of the laser dot in the camera's field of view. These three pieces of information fully determine the shape and size of the triangle and give the location of the laser dot. Corner of the triangle, in most cases a laser stripe, instead of a single laser dot, is swept across the object to speed up the acquisition process. The National Research Council of Canada was among the first institutes to develop the triangulation-based laser scanning technology in 1978. Strengths and weaknesses: time of flight and triangulation range finders each have strengths and weaknesses that make them suitable for different situations. The advantage of time of flight range finders is that they are capable of operating over very long distances, on the order of kilometers. These scanners are thus suitable for scanning large structures like buildings or geographic features. The disadvantage of time of flight range finders is their accuracy due to the high speed of light. Timing the round trip time is difficult, and the accuracy of the distance measurement is relatively low, on the order of millimeters. Triangulation range finders are exactly the opposite. They have a limited range of some meters, but their accuracy is relatively high. The accuracy of triangulation range finders is on the order of tens of micrometers. Time of flight scanner's accuracy can be lost when the laser hits the edge of an object because the information that is sent back to the scanner is from two different locations. For one laser pulse, the coordinate relative to the scanner's position for a point that has hit the edge of an object will be calculated based on an average and therefore will put the point in the wrong place. When using a high-resolution scan on an object, the chances of the beam hitting an edge are increased, and the resulting data will show noise just behind the edges of the object. Scanners with with a smaller beam width will help to solve this problem but will be limited by range as the beam width will increase over distance. Software can also help by determining that the first object to be hit by the laser beam should cancel out the second at a rate of 10,000 sample points per second. Low-resolution scans can take less than a second, but high-resolution scans, requiring millions of samples, can take minutes for some time of flight scanners. The problem this creates is distortion from motion since each point is sampled at a different time. Any motion in the subject or the scanner will distort the collected data. Thus, it is usually necessary to mount both the subject and the scanner on stable platforms and minimize vibration. Using these scanners to scan objects in motion is very difficult. Recently, there has been research on compensating for distortion from small amounts of vibration and distortions due to motion and or rotation when scanning in one position for any length of time. Slight movement can occur in the scanner position due to changes in temperature. If the scanner is set on a tripod and there is strong sunlight on one side of the scanner, then that side of the tripod will expand and slowly distort the scan data from one side to another. Some laser scanners have level compensators built into them to counteract any movement of the scanner during the scan process. Kinoscopic holography in a kinoscopic system, a laser beam is projected onto the surface and then the immediate reflection along the same ray path are put through a kinoscopic crystal and projected onto a CCD. The result is a diffraction pattern that can be frequency analyzed to determine the distance to the measured surface. The main advantage with kinoscopic holography is that only a single ray path is needed for measuring, thus giving an opportunity to measure, for instance, the depth of a finely drilled hole using a periscope allows access into small diameter holes to measure the bottom and side walls. Handheld laser scanners create a 3D image through the triangulation mechanism described above. A laser dot or line is projected onto an object from a handheld device, and a sensor, typically a charge-coupled device or position-sensitive device, measures the distance to the surface. Data is collected in relation to an internal coordinate system, and therefore to collect data where the scanner is in motion, the position of the scanner must be determined. The position can be determined by the scanner using reference features on the surface being scanned, typically adhesive reflective tabs, but natural features have been also used in research work or by using an external tracking method. External tracking often takes the form of a laser tracker to provide the sensor position with integrated camera to determine the orientation of the scanner, or a photogrammetric solution using three or more cameras providing the complete 6 degrees of freedom of the scanner. Both techniques tend to use infrared light emitting diodes attached to the scanner, which are seen by the cameras through filters providing resilience to ambient lighting. Data is collected by a computer and recorded as data points within three-dimensional space. With processing, this can be converted into a triangulated mesh and then a computer-aided design model, often as non-uniform rational B-spline surfaces. Handheld laser scanners can combine this data with passive, visible light sensors, which capture surface textures and colors, to build or reverse engineer a full 3D model. Structured light. Main article, structured light 3D scanner. Structured light 3D scanners project a pattern of light on the subject and look at the deformation of the pattern on the subject. The pattern is projected onto the subject using either an LCD projector or other stable light source. A camera, offset slightly from the pattern projector, looks at the shape of the pattern and calculates the distance of every point in the field of view. Structured light scanning is still a very active area of research, with many research papers published each year. Perfect maps have also been proven useful as structured light patterns that solve the correspondence problem and allow for error detection and error correction. See Moran R. et al. Structured light using pseudorandom codes, IEEE transactions on pattern analysis and machine intelligence. The advantage of structured light 3D scanners is speed and precision. Instead of scanning one point at a time, structured light scanners scan multiple points or the entire field of view at once. Scanning an entire field of view in a fraction of a second reduces or eliminates the problem of distortion from motion. Some existing systems are capable of scanning moving objects in real-time. Vision Master creates a 3D scanning system with a 5-megapixel camera. 5 million data points are acquired in every frame. A real-time scanner using digital fringe projection and phase shifting technique. Certain kinds of structured light methods was developed to capture, reconstruct, and render high-density details of dynamically deformable objects such as facial expressions at 40 frames per second. Recently, another scanner has been developed. Different patterns can be applied to this system, and the frame rate for capturing and data processing achieves 120 frames per second. It can also scan isolated surfaces, for example two moving hands, by utilizing the binary defocusing technique. Speed breakthroughs have been made that could reach hundreds of to thousands of frames per second. Modulated light 3D scanners shine a continually changing light at the subject. Usually the light source simply cycles its amplitude in a sinusoidal pattern. A camera detects the reflected light, and the amount the pattern is shifted by determines the distance the light traveled. Modulated light also allows the scanner to ignore light from sources other than a laser, so there is no interference. Volumetric techniques. Medical computed tomography CT is a medical imaging method which generates a three-dimensional image of the inside of an object from a large series of two-dimensional X-ray images. Similarly, magnetic resonance imaging is another medical imaging technique that provides much greater contrast between the different soft tissues of the body than computed tomography CT does, making it especially useful in neurological brain, musculoskeletal, cardiovascular, and oncological cancer imaging. These techniques produce a discrete 3D volumetric representation that can be directly visualized, manipulated, or converted to traditional 3D surface by means of isosurface extraction algorithms. Industrial, although most common in medicine, industrial computed tomography, microtomography, and MRI are also used in other fields for acquiring a digital representation of an object and its interior, such as non-destructive materials testing, reverse engineering, or studying biological and paleontological specimens. Non-contact passive 3D imaging solutions do not emit any kind of radiation themselves, but instead rely on detecting reflected ambient radiation. Most solutions of this type detect visible light because it is a readily available ambient radiation. Other types of radiation, such as infrared, could also be used. Passive methods can be very cheap, because in most cases they do not need particular hardware but simple digital cameras. Stereoscopic systems usually employ two video cameras, slightly apart, looking at the same scene by analyzing the slight differences between the images seen by each camera. It is possible to determine the distance at each point in the images. This method is based on the same principles driving human stereoscopic vision. Photometric systems usually use a single camera, but take multiple images under varying lighting conditions. These techniques attempt to invert the image formation model in order to recover the surface orientation at each pixel. Silhouette techniques use outlines created from a sequence of photographs around a three-dimensional object against a well-contrasted background. These silhouettes are extruded and intersected to form the visual hull approximation of the object. With these approaches, some concavities of an object, like the interior of a bowl, cannot be detected. User-assisted image-based modeling. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. October 2010. There are other methods that, based on the user-assisted detection and identification of some features and shapes on a set of different pictures of an object, are able to build an approximation of the object itself. This kind of techniques are useful to build fast approximation of simple shaped objects like buildings. Various commercial packages are available, like D-Sculptor, iModeler, Autodesk Image Modeler, 123D Catch, or Photo Modeler. This sort of 3D imaging solution is based on the principles of photogrammetry. It is also somewhat similar in methodology to panoramic photography, except that the photos are taken of one object on a three-dimensional space in order to replicate it, instead of taking a series of photos from one point in a three-dimensional space in order to replicate the surrounding environment. Reconstruction from point clouds. The point clouds produced by 3D scanners and 3D imaging can be used directly for measurement and visualization in the architecture and construction world. From models, most applications, however, use instead polygonal 3D models, NURBS surface models, or editable feature-based CAD models, aka solid models, polygon mesh models. In a polygonal representation of a shape, a curved surface is modeled as many small faceted flat surfaces. Think of a sphere modeled as a disco ball. Polygon models, also called mesh models, are useful for visualization, for some CAM, i.e., machining, but are generally heavy, i.e., very large data sets, and are relatively uneditable in this form. Reconstruction to polygonal model involves finding and connecting adjacent points with straight lines in order to create a continuous surface. Many applications, both free and non-free, are available for this purpose, e.g. MeshLab, PointCap, Qubit Point Cloud for AutoCAD, JRC 3D Reconstructor, ImageModel, PolyWorks, RapidForm, Geomagic, ImageWare, Rhino 3D, etc. Surface models. The next level of sophistication in modeling involves using a quilt of curved surface patches to model our shape. These might be nerves, T-splines, or other curved representations of curved topology using nerves. Our sphere is a true mathematical sphere. Some applications offer patch layout by hand, but the best in class offer both automated patch layout and manual layout. These patches have the advantage of being lighter and more manipulable when exported to CAD. Surface models are somewhat editable, but only in a sculptural sense of pushing and pulling to deform the surface. This representation lends itself well to modeling organic and artistic shapes. Providers of surface modelers include RapidForm, Geomagic, Rhino 3D Maya, T-splines, etc. Solid CAD models, from an engineering, manufacturing perspective, the ultimate representation of a digitized shape is the editable, parametric CAD model. After all, CAD is the common language of industry to describe, edit, and maintain the shape of the enterprise's assets in CAD. Our sphere is described by parametric features which are easily edited by changing a value, e.g., center point and radius. These CAD models describe not simply the envelope or shape of the object, but CAD models also embody the design intent, i.e., critical features and their relationship to other features. An example of design intent not evident in the shape alone might be a brake drum's lug bolts, which must be concentric with the hole in the center of the drum. This knowledge would drive the sequence and method of creating the CAD model. A designer with an awareness of this relationship would not design the lug bolts referenced to the outside diameter, but instead, to the center. A modeler creating a CAD model will want to include both shape and design intent in the complete CAD model. Vendors offer different approaches to getting to the parametric CAD model. Some export the NURBS surfaces and leave it to the CAD designer to complete the model in CAD, e.g., Geomagic, Imageware, Rhino 3D. Others use the scan data to create an editable and verifiable feature-based model that is imported into CAD with full feature tree intact, yielding a complete, native CAD model, capturing both shape and design intent, e.g. Geomagic, RapidForm. Still other CAD applications are robust enough to manipulate limited points or polygon models within the CAD environment, e.g., CATIA, AutoCAD, Revit. From a set of 2D slices, 3D reconstruction of the brain and eyeballs from CT scan DICOM images. In this image, areas with the density of bone or air were made transparent, and the slices stacked up in an approximate free space alignment. The outer ring of material around the brain are the soft tissues of skin and muscle. On the outside of the skull, a black box encloses the slices to provide the black background. Since these are simply 2D images stacked up, when viewed on edge the slices disappear since they have effectively zero thickness. Each DICOM scan represents about 5 mm of material averaged into a thin slice. CT, industrial CT, MRI, or micro CT scanners do not produce point clouds but a set of 2D slices, each termed a tomogram, which are then stacked together to produce a 3D representation. There are several ways to do this depending on the output required. Volume rendering: different parts of an object usually have different threshold values or grayscale densities. From this, a three-dimensional model can be constructed and displayed on screen. Multiple models can be constructed from various thresholds, allowing different colors to represent each component of the object. Volume rendering is usually only used for visualization of the scanned object. Image segmentation, where different structures have similar threshold grayscale values, it can become impossible to separate them simply by adjusting volume rendering parameters. The solution is called segmentation, a manual or automatic procedure that can remove the unwanted structures from the image. Image segmentation software usually allows export of the segmented structures in CAD or STL format for further manipulation. Image-based meshing, when using 3D image data for computational analysis, e.g. CFD and FI, simply segmenting the data and meshing from CAD can become time-consuming, and virtually intractable for the complex topologies typical of image data. The solution is called image-based meshing, an automated process of generating an accurate and realistic geometrical description of the scan data. From laser scans, laser scanning describes the general method to sample or scan a surface using laser technology. Several areas of application exist that mainly differ in the power of the lasers that are used, and in the results of the scanning process. Low laser power is used when the scanned surface doesn't have to be influenced, e.g. when it only has to be digitized. Confocal or 3D laser scanning are methods to get information about the scanned surface. Another low power application uses structured light projection systems for solar cell flatness metrology, enabling stress calculation throughout in excess of 2,000 wafers per hour. The laser power used for laser scanning equipment in industrial applications is typically less than 1 W. The power level is usually on the order of 200. Quantity surveys freeway redesign establishing a benchmark of pre-existing shape state in order to detect structural changes resulting from exposure to extreme loadings such as earthquake, vessel, truck impact or fire create GIS geographic information system maps and geomatics subsurface laser scanning in mines and karst voids forensic documentation design process increasing accuracy working with complex parts and shapes, coordinating product design using parts from multiple sources, updating old CD scans with those from more current technology, replacing missing or older parts, creating cost savings by allowing as-built design services, for example in automotive manufacturing plants, bringing the plant to the engineers with web-shared scans, and saving travel costs entertainment. 3D scanners are used by the entertainment industry to create digital 3D models for movies, video games and leisure purposes. They're heavily utilized in virtual cinematography in cases where a real-world equivalent of a model exists. It is much faster to scan the real-world object than to manually create a model using 3D modeling software frequently. Artists sculpt physical models of what they want and scan them into digital form rather than directly creating digital models on a computer. Law enforcement 3D laser scanning is used by the FBI. 3D models are used for on-site documentation of crime scenes, bullet trajectory, accident reconstruction, bombings, plane crashes, and more. Reverse engineering. Reverse engineering of a mechanical component requires a precise digital model of the objects to be reproduced rather than a set of points. A precise digital model can be represented by a polygon mesh, a set of flat or curved NURBS surfaces, or ideally for mechanical components, a CAD solid model. A 3D scanner can be used to digitize free-form or gradually changing shaped components as well as prismatic geometries, whereas a coordinate measuring machine is usually used only to determine simple dimensions of a highly prismatic model. These data points are then processed to create a usable digital model, usually using specialized reverse engineering software. Cultural heritage. There have been many research projects undertaken via the scanning of historical sites and artifacts both for documentation and analysis purposes. The combined use of 3D scanning and 3D printing technologies allows the replication of real objects without the use of traditional plaster casting techniques, that in many cases can be too invasive for being performed on precious or delicate cultural heritage artifacts. In an example of a typical application scenario, a gargoyle model was digitally acquired using a 3D scanner and the produced 3D data was processed using MeshLab. The resulting digital 3D model was fed to a rapid prototyping machine to create a real resin replica of the original object. Michelangelo. In 1999, two different research groups started scanning Michelangelo's statues. Stanford University, with a group led by Mark Lavoie, used a custom laser triangulation scanner built by Cyberware to scan Michelangelo's statues in Florence, notably the David, the Prigioni, and the four statues in the Medici Chapel. The scans produced a data point density of 1 sample per 0.25. Different angles of Jefferson's cabinet cuneiform tablets. In 2003, Subodh Kumar, et al. Undertook the 3D scanning of ancient cuneiform tablets again. A laser triangulation scanner was used. The tablets were scanned on a regular grid pattern at a resolution of 0.025. Parts of the model. Other projects. The 3D Encounters project at the Petrie Museum of Egyptian Archaeology aims to use 3D laser scanning to create a high-quality 3D image library of artifacts and enable digital traveling exhibitions of fragile Egyptian artifacts. English Heritage has investigated the use of 3D laser scanning for a wide range of applications to gain archaeological and condition data, and the National Conservation Centre in Liverpool has also produced 3D laser scans on commission, including portable object and in situ scans of archaeological sites. The Smithsonian Institution has a project called Smithsonian X3D, notable for the breadth of types of 3D objects they are attempting to scan. These include small objects such as insects and flowers, to human-sized objects such as Amelia Earhart's flight suit, to room-sized objects such as the gunboat Philadelphia, to historic sites such as Liang Bua in Indonesia. Also of note, the data from these scans is being made available to the public for free and downloadable in several data formats. Medical CAD, CAM 3D scanners are used to capture the 3D shape of a patient. In orthotics and dentistry, it gradually supplants tedious plaster cast. CAD, CAM software are then used to design and manufacture the orthosis, prosthesis or dental implants. Many chairside dental CAD/CAM systems and dental laboratory CAD/CAM systems use 3D scanner technologies to capture the 3D surface of a dental preparation either in vivo or in vitro, in order to produce a restoration digitally using CAD software and ultimately produce the final restoration using a CAM technology such as a CNC milling machine, or 3D printer. The chairside systems are designed to facilitate the 3D scanning of a preparation in vivo and produce the restoration such as a crown, onlay, inlay or veneer. Quality assurance and industrial metrology. The digitalization of real-world objects is of vital importance in various application domains. This method is especially applied in industrial quality assurance to measure the geometric dimension accuracy. Industrial processes such as assembly are complex, highly automated and typically based on CAD computer-aided design data. The problem is that the same degree of automation is also required for quality assurance. It is, for example, a very complex task to assemble a modern car, since it consists of many parts that must fit together at the very end of the production line. The optimal performance of this process is guaranteed by quality assurance systems. Especially the geometry of the metal parts must be checked in order to assure that they have the correct dimensions, fit together and finally work reliably within highly automated processes. The resulting geometric measures are transferred to machines that manufacture the desired objects due to mechanical uncertainties and abrasions. The result may differ from its digital nominal. In order to automatically capture and evaluate these deviations, the manufactured part must be digitized as well. For this purpose, 3D scanners are applied to generate point samples from the object's surface, which are finally compared against the nominal data. The process of comparing 3D data against a CAD model is referred to as CAD compare, and can be a useful technique for applications such as determining wear patterns on molds and tooling, determining accuracy of final build, analyzing gap and flush, or analyzing highly complex sculpted surfaces. At present, laser triangulation scanners, structured light and contact scanning are the predominant technologies employed for industrial purposes, with contact scanning remaining the slowest, but overall most accurate option. Nevertheless, 3D scanning technology offers distinct advantages compared to traditional touch probe measurements. White light or laser scanners accurately digitize objects all around, capturing fine details and freeform surfaces without reference points, or spray the entire surface is covered at record speed without the risk of damaging the part. Graphic comparison charts illustrate geometric deviations of full object level, providing deeper insights into potential causes. See also Design Portal 3D printing. 3D reconstruction. 3D computer graphics software. Angle sensitive pixel depth map. Epipolar geometry. Full body scanner. Light field camera. Photogrammetry. Range imaging. Structured light. 3D scanner. References. Carrot. Fausto Bernardini, Holly E. Rushmeyer. 2002. The 3D model acquisition pipeline. PDF. Compute Graph Forum 21:2-149-172. DOI 101,111/1467-865,900,574. OCLC. Hassebrook 2010. Dual frequency pattern scheme for high-speed 3D shape measurement. PDF. Optics Express 18:5-5229-5244. DOI 101,364/OE18005229-PMID. Korea, December 2003. Carrot. Murphy, Liam. Case study: Old mine workings. Subsurface laser scanning case studies. Liam Murphy. Retrieved the 11th of January 2012. Carrot. Roberto Scopagno, Susanna Bracci, Folletti, Franca, Mauro Mattini. 2004. Exploring David diagnostic tests and state of conservation. Gruppo Editorial Giunti. ISBN. DOI 105,334/JCMS1021201.